I am very much happy to welcome you all for this optical communication lecture series. This from this presentation, let us discuss avalanche photodiode working process and operation. This disclaimer is applicable to all the participants, those who are all listening in online platform. After listening that video or presentation, students might be aware about the working process of avalanche photodiode and the importance of avalanche effect. So let us discuss avalanche photodiode operation. It sends the luminescent power falling on it and converts the variations of optical power into corresponding electrical current. So the luminescent means brightness of the light signal. That signal has to convert it as an electric current. Then construction and operation. In this diode, primary photocurrent is internally multiplied. So the purpose of the primary photocurrent is to increase the sensitivity of receiver. Since photocurrent is multiplied before encountering the thermal noise associated with the receiver circuit. So as I know, the purpose of avalanche photodiode is to convert light energy into electrical energy. Also, in order to improve the sensitivity, receiver sensitivity, the photocurrent plays major role. So this is reached through avalanche photodiode RAPD structure and its electric field operation. So we just look into here. This is P plus is placed at the epistaxial layer, I mean bottom of the layer. So P, that plus mark shows heavily doped P type material and then followed by I. Then P material is lightly doped. So because of the minimum impurity presence, it produces high conductivity. So also it produces, it has less resistivity, because of that it conduct much more. Then last one is N plus layer, heavily doped N layer. So in between that PN plus junction alone, that avalanche region cast. The detailed working process let us discuss in subsequent slide. So in order for carrier multiplication to take place, the photo generated carriers must traverse the region where very high electric field is present. Then impact ionization. In this field, a photo generated electron or hole can gain enough energy so that it ionizes bond electrons in valence band upon colliding with them. This carrier multiplication mechanism is called as impact ionization. So we just observe that in our subsequent study, we observe that process. Avalanche effect. The newly created carriers are accelerated by high electric field. It's gained enough energy. It is a root cause for further impact ionization. This phenomenon is called as avalanche effect. Both impact ionization and avalanche effect we will discuss in our next slide with the diagrammatic approach. So just see here, the commonly used structure for achieving carrier multiplication is very little excess noise is enough reach through construction. The reach through avalanche photodiode is composed with high resistivity of p-type material deposited as an epitaxy layer, I mean bottom layer, heavily doped. Then p-type diffusion or ion implantation is made on the high resistivity material, followed by the construction of n plus. The silicon dopants are used for form the layers, normally borons and phosphorus respectively. This configuration known as p plus pi p n plus, that is called reach through structure. Now let us discuss. The first layer is p plus layer and the last layer is n plus layer. In between p and pi layer is located. Both p plus and n plus layers are connected as reverse bias process. So once if we connect the reverse bias process, means electrons and hole pair has been created in p plus region. Then slowly, whenever we have been increased bias voltage near to avalanche breakdown voltage, means that electrons hole pairs, more number of electron and hole pair created in pi region. So initially, once they establish the reverse bias voltage, means certain number of electrons and hole pairs has been created in P plus layer. Whenever I have increased that reverse bias voltage near to avalanche breakdown region means that number of electron hole pairs increased much more in that pi region. Then after that, that electrons and hole pairs has to travel with the saturation, high saturation velocity. By the time that electrons and hole pairs travel with this n plus p junction, in between this n plus b junction, depletion layer is there. In that high velocity of electrons and hole pairs were collided with that depletion region. By the time carrier multiplication formed. So whenever keep on increasing that process means more number of carrier multiplication process are called. That is called as impact ionization. That electrons and more number of electron and hole pairs keep on in colliding with depletion layer atoms. By the time more number of carriers are produced, that process is called as carrier multiplication. In general, that carrier multiplication process is referred as impact ionization. Whenever that electrons and hole pairs keep on colliding with the depletion region means in that phase, that atom produce much more amount of current. That is called as avalanche effect. So that things alone we have been discussed in our previous slide. So once again repeated, both impact ionization and avalanche effects are very much important concept. So initially, whenever we have been applied the reverse bias voltage, electrons and hole pairs keep on increases. Then whenever increasing the bias voltage near to avalanche breakdown voltage means that electrons and hole pairs has to travel with the saturation velocity. So because of that saturation velocity, much more saturation velocity, it has to reach with n plus p junction depletion layer. So in the depletion layer also, atoms also collide with electrons and hole pairs, it forms some pairs, some carriers. Then continuously that electrons and hole pairs keep on colliding with that depletion layer atoms, it produces multiple number of carriers. That is called as photomultiplication carrier. That photomultiplication carrier produces much more amount of current. That is called as avalanche effect. High amount of electric current is called as avalanche effect. Much more amount of photo carrier produced by the depletion layer, which is colloid with electrons and hole pairs, that is called as impact ionization. So the commonly used structure for achieving carrier multiplication is very little. Excess noise in noise through construction. So RAPD composed of high resistivity p-type material deposited as an epitaxial layer. That things have also seen. Avalanche photodiode working process. As we said in our previous slide explanation itself, the term reach through arises from the photodiode operation. When a low reverse bias voltage is applied over here, low reverse bias voltage applied over here means potential drop happened in our PN junction. So in order to avoid that potential drop, we are going to increase that reverse bias voltage nearer to avalanche breakdown. So by the time PN plus junction fully formed as a depletion mode, once light enters through the P plus region, it absorbed and then formed electrons and hole pairs. Those electrons and hole pairs moved with high velocity, saturation velocity. Saturation velocity of these electrons and hole pair collided with N plus P junction depletion mode. By the time it produced much more amount of electric current, that is called as impact ionization or avalanche. The much more amount of electric current is referred as avalanche effect. Ionization rate, which is defined as average number of electrons and hole pairs created by carrier per unit distance traveled in a, is called ionization rate. Most of the materials exhibit different ionization rates alpha and hole ionization rate beta. So ionization rate k is equal to beta divided by alpha. Multiplication factor, the multiplication factor m for all carriers generated in photodiode defined by M. M is equal to Im divided by Ip. Advantage of avalanche photodiode. It detects very weak signal. It produces high gain. Disadvantages. construction is quite complicated. Specific has been taken. Output is non-linear. It operates high operating voltage. Application. Detection of low signal. It is used to fiber optic communication system. References. Optical fiber communications authored by Gerard Geiser. Page number in between 251 to 253. So let us recap what are the concepts behind this avalanche photodiode. So the purpose of photodiodes are to convert electric current to convert optical signal into electric current. So in that in order to meet that objective, avalanche photodiode is used. So in our conventional photodiode as well as PIN photodiode produce very minimum current, also produce very minimum gain. So in order to improve that gain, we are going for avalanche photodiode. So avalanche photodiode consists the structure like P plus I P N plus. So initially we need to connect reverse bias voltage. So once the reverse bias voltage connected means that electrons and hole pairs has been formed slowly. Then whenever we have been increased the reverse bias voltage nearer to avalanche breakdown voltage means the number of electrons per hole pair slowly rise in that pi region also. Then this electrons and hole pairs traveled with saturation velocity. Well, because of the saturation velocity, that electrons and hole pairs or electrons and hole carriers reach to n plus p junction. In that junction alone, depletion layers are there. So these electrons and hole pairs with the high saturation velocity colliding with other atoms, it forms depletion region. So because of the collision of electrons and hole pairs with other atom, it produces multiple carriers. That is called as carrier multiplication. Because of that carrier multiplication, it produces much more current. That is called as avalanche effect. So because of this avalanche effect, this avalanche photodiode produces high gain. Then followed by, we have been seen advantages and disadvantages. So those things are very important. Because of low signal level detection, it has been used for optical fiber communication. Thank you.